There's art out there today that's just shocking. You've seen it and wondered, what in the world is going on here? That's crazy. That doesn't make any sense. Now, why would somebody do that? Well, it's nothing new. In 1865, Edouard Manet shocked the viewers at the French Salon with his painting, Olympia. A full 4x6 feet painting of sex. Not nude Greek goddesses, but straight up prostitution. More than just being formally weird to the upstanding salon goer, it was, well, you know, shocking. How about to the connoisseurs of the time? Maybe some quit. They quit keeping up with Manet after his antics, siding with the salon, and also keeping their pockets intact, financially that is. Maybe some continue to study the formal qualities of Manet's work, remaining neutral, or even siding with Manet. Either way, Manet's Olympia left connoisseurs puzzled. What was he doing? Where is modern art going? Now, how about today? Are there any contemporary examples? Sex and nudity are far from shocking today. So what is shocking in the art world? Maybe Yasumasa Morimura 1988 work portrait. Hey now, okay, that's shocking. But is it really? Morimura is using Manet's Olympia not as a shock factor, but to take the issue of who's looking at who even further. He doesn't merely neutralize the spectator's gaze, but controls it with his own. Maybe that has something to do with shock in art. It not only jars the physical senses, but it also controls the viewer's perspective. It leaves you almost speechless. So, are there any contemporary equivalents to Manet's Olympia? I don't think that there are any. But can art still shock us today? I think so. But it will really depend on the art and on the person viewing it. And I wonder even if that will be true in the coming years.